Music washes away the dust of everyday life from the soul. The saying was indeed true. We all love music. Also, we don't prefer any kind of disturbance or ad in between. But this seems impossible without a paid subscription. So let's try to design a music player just like the way we want. Basically, here is the application which we are creating today. Here is the music player application which we will be creating today in this video. This is a simple tutorial that will cover up how to create this minimal music player using Tkinter and a pygame module. Well, we have four functionality here. First one is play, second one is pause, stop and resume. Basically, these are the four basic functions that a music player must contain. So the basic Python concept consists of the Tkinter. To install the libraries, you can use the pip installer from the command prompt or terminal. So basically, let me show you where I have kept all this file. So here I have a Python project that consists of the music player. Well, this is great, right? So I'm gonna be creating this simple project using some techniques and core concept of Python. Basically, we will be using the two libraries. So let me just get into my code and show you how I have created this application. So here is the basic application. So here is the import statement which will import the pygame module. And now we need the mixer here. So it will basically import the pygame. So I will recommend you to import all the stuff from pygame. To do so, you can write import pygame, or you may can also write from pygame and then import, and then you need to just give an star mark out right there. Now this statement means the same here, all right there. So this statement is the same thing, all right there. So let me just cut this up. Okay, so after that being done, you need to import the mixer and then Tkinter. Now we need to import the OS, but first of all, let me explain you what this star means. This star means that we need to import all the things from that library. Basically, it will include all the stuff. So here is the OS. Basically, this OS referred to the library which I have here. So basically, this is the Python project and here is my music. All the kind of things are there. So it directly refers to there, so that we can import the OS module. Now this module is a really functional module in order to get the data from your computer. Okay, let's define some function, right? So here are some function. We need to play the song. So to do so, I will write define play song. Now this line of statement will basically define a function. Now in order to get the function or the song, what we need to write is current song. We need to get a variable, right? So we need to create a playlist first. Now in order to get the playlist, you can just go to your music folder and get this playlist. But I have here all the things right there. So basically, after that, we need to print the current music file, which directly refers to the song that had been played out right there. Now we need to load the song in order to play it. Now the mixer function, basically we have imported it out right here. You can see we have the pygame function here. Now this will basically allow us to get the music and play it on the way. So now we need to load it. So to load it, I will write mixer.music.load and the current song, which values directly refers to this variable which we have created. Now we need to make a song status in order to get the playing or pause music. So as we are playing the song, it will display playing. And finally, the play function. Now this play function will basically play the music for you, which is really great. Now let's come up to the pause function here. So I have created a pause function just to make sure that the music should pause at a moment. To set it, I will just type here that song status, set it to pause. Basically what we have done in this previous paragraphs. So let me go here and show you what is this mixer.music pause means. Basically this function is same as this one. It is a function which we are using from its module, and it's like pause function. So basically it will just pause the music, right? So we need to first of all define what is the mixer and then the music, and we need to just define the pause function. Now we don't want any argument outright here. Okay, So in order to stop the song, we need to define a stop song function. So similar way, we need to set the type to stopped basically, and then we need to import another function here from that is mixer.music.stop, and basically here are no argument, basically you don't need any argument out right there, so it's a great deal, right? So now to resume the song, we just want to set that song status to be resuming and the music to be unpaused. Now as per the value, I need to define the root here. Now the root directly means to tkinter or kinter panel. So this will directly refers to this root here. So this root directly refers to the tkinter or kinter. Now we need to define the title here. So basically you can, these are the basic function that we have already used in our previous applications and softwares. Now you can write anything right there in place of this music player and something like that. You can just write type anything and this will be your title basically. Now we need to just define where our files are basically. So its init function will basically do it for us. And then we have the song status. We need to make sure that this is a string variable in order to display directly to the GUI or GUI. So this will do it. And now we need to choose the song, right? So basically we will be using the choosing function right there. So let's create the playlist here. Basically let's define the playlist. Now this is the thing which we need right down there. So this will basically choose a root file and select mode is single, and I have just defined some kind of GUI or designing element right there. I have changed the foreground, background, fonts and width, all this kind of thing. So now we need to specify the playlist. These are the playlist basically, where I have set it the column span to be 5, and here are the things that we need. Basically this is my Windows kind of thing. For Mac OS you can just change this value here. I've just changed it to the music as per my Windows, as I was working on with that for some time, so it was there. So this is the OS list dictionary, which will basically create all the songs, all the list of that file which are present in your song dictionary, which will basically refer to this line of code. So basically we need to create a loop here so that we can play and pause the song, right? So for S in songs, S here refers to the song basically which are present in that song dictionary right there. We need to insert everything into our music player. So if anybody choose any music, then it will directly insert it to our music player. Now this is a great deal. Now we need some button to play it, right? So I have created here a button. Now this button is directly created with using the Tkinter module. And here is the config. Now the config, you can use the kind of GUI's element or kind of thing like that. So now the grid will help you to directly arrange those buttons in some spacing. And here is the button basically. This button directly refers to the pause, and we have set it the command to be pause song. Now this command you can see here, basically this command directly refers to the code here. Let me show you which it is referring to. So basically this is referring to the function that we have created out right there. You can see here the function basically. So yeah, that is the thing. Now here is the main loop basically. Now these are the same things here. We have the stop song and we have the resume kind of thing like that. You need to just make sure that you give a command here, and then we need to specify that which command it should follow or which function it should follow. And there are some designing element which are hanging out right there. And now we need to close that loop, right? We have created the Tkinter loop. So main, loop and empty brackets. Now this will basically help you to close that loop. Now in order to export this project into your Git, what can you do is basically go over to your GitHub page and you can publish it out right there. And you can just choose this initialize and publish on Git, and you can just publish it here out right there. So great deal, right? Now to make sure that where your files are, you can use this function here. Let me show you. Basically this is the folder where we need to specify all the kind of music. So here are all the files. Now before creating the project, you make sure that you create a file above this folder, and just name it something like music player.py. Basically this is the thing. So this command will help you to initialize the OS system, and this will also help you to be keeping your project clean out right here. Okay, so we don't need it anymore. So we have already created the project, and after saving it, you make sure to open it up, and here is the basic project which we have created. Let me show you all right here. So this is the application, and after doing so, just open up the application and you will get this music player project which we have created. And let me just play this song and let me just show you how it works. And yeah, the pause function does work. And let's use the stop function. And yes, it works. Now again play. Okay, all the functions work well. So right, it's great. So basically this GUI is not great, right? So I offer you can create a GUI using our latest app, which is Proxcode out right there. You can try this application directly from the link given below, where you can create HTML, CSS, JavaScript, all this kind of designing element to create a design for yourself. And you can watch all the YIL tutorial which I have created later on, and you can just use them as a reference in order to get the nice thing, and you can use it to make your front end look beautiful and great. So this was it, guys, and I hope this tutorial was really helpful for you. And if this was helpful, then consider subscribing and hit the like button below. Goodbye.